In your speech, you were talking about persistence. Why is that important? How can we incorporate this quality to succeed in technology as women?
Yes, indeed, because persistence is about courage, and especially in the technical world, women and also men, they will be, they will encounter certain things that will test them. It's just like being in training, and you have to decide. It's like goal setting. You know, what am I going to accomplish here at a meeting? What I want to accomplish in my career? For the example, this year for me is about complete my degree is an example, which I have done. My key message is don't give up. It's too easy to walk away. That's persistence in a nutshell.
How do we realize the moment when we have to give up?
So, and that's a fine art, that's also the art. So what I mean by persistence is always being true to yourself. You don't want to give up so easily. You have to ask yourself at which point, weigh the odds, that what I want to do or what I want to accomplish, whether it's with a project or in an organization, it's just not going to move anymore. Do you not stay true to yourself and stay in the organization or, stay with the project? Or not stay with the project, or if the project is not going to get funding, then that's probably the time to say, I need to give it up. I need, as much as I love this project, I'm going to have to let it go.
Everything is so fast nowadays, digital technologies. Are we still in charge with what is happening, or are the digital technologies kind of shaping our lives more, or is it like mutual process?
No, I will argue that we need to be back in control. I don't think we're in the control that we should be in. I talk about data privacy and how you are actually how you are a piece of data or metadata yourself. So I think we need to understand what companies and organizations are doing with ourselves and our data. The other thing is, when you leave a digital footprint on the internet, no matter what it looks like, you can never get rid of it. So it's all about you being in the center of this Copernican, universe, and you selectively, this is my really passionate pitch, sharing what you want to share with the organizations that you care about. And I think that's really important. So there should be nobody in the middle, because what happens is your data, what we're seeing is getting more and more abused. There are hacks, there are personal hacks, there are identity thefts, and we, until something happens bad to you or that is egregious, we start to care. But we should start to care now.
So is there some simple advice individuals can do to protect more their privacy?
Yes, indeed. I mean, I think that you have to watch the kind of apps that you download, because there's a correlation to privacy and cybersecurity. You have to look at, if somebody wants to connect to you and you don't know that person, don't connect. You have to look at the security capabilities on your phone, and use them. Probably have to put screens on your cameras or your laptops and on your microphones and so on. These are the very basic things that we should be paying attention to. And watch what you tweet. Watch what you tweet. Watch what you, put out on the internet, because you can never, ever take it back. You have forensic dust that's out there forever and ever. So those are the basic things.
What do you think events like Ada Lovelace, Switzerland Satellite are important for women in technology or in technology in general?
Well, I think as a start, it's a great start, and I'd like to see more attendees next year. I think we need to have, as Miriam stated, there are only 15% of women in the Swiss technical world, and I think we need to have more of that. We need to have a world in the technology world, world itself, where we have some kind of equal footing, equal in the room, etc. This is a great start. It's a great platform to have candid conversations with one another, so we need that. And I love listening to, learning something new about our quantum computing future. So
if you could sum up, why is it important to have women in technology?
We're 51% of the world's population as a start. Women control quite a bit of spend, consumer spend. I think that's a big issue. So, and if you have a phone, that's technology. It makes sense to have women in technology, and we have to be able to move away from the cognitive biases that are surrounding us. I think that there is so much room for women to play a special role in technology, and for me, I was once told that you'll have to wait another generation before that happens. We're in the 21st century, and we're still asking this question. So for me, I will not sleep well at night until I see equal footing on this, in this topic.